Hey guys, how's it going and welcome back to the channel. So this is the last in the series of the tornado build. I was going to do this in two parts, but I decided as part of the weathering ended up in this video anyway because of the way I'm doing this one. I thought I might as well just make it into one whole video. So in this video we'll be looking at the paint of the model, some of the small details going in, obviously the weathering. So at the end of the video, as always in the last of the series, I'll be obviously showcasing the model off, but also in the end of this video I'll sort of do my thoughts of the kit and what's coming up next. So stick with us and we'll see you in a few minutes. Thank you.
Thank you.
So there we go, guys. Obviously, I didn't show you all of the little bits and pieces going in because I wanted to save them for now. But before we go and reveal the finished kit, scissors before, you know, my thoughts on the kit. It's quite good, actually. It's an old kit. I think it's 1989 kit with revamped box and instructions. But generally, it was a good kit. One or two fitting issues, but nothing that was major. Basically, just a bit in the manipulation when you glue it together. The only thing, and I don't know actually how I didn't notice this, and I'll show you these now, because I'm all up for being honest with you guys, and I don't mind showing my cock-ups, as I'm sure you've seen in one of the other previous builds with this kit where I dropped it. Don't know how I did that, but anyway. I found this when I was painting, and I could have actually done it, but by that point I was like, I kind of actually want to finish it. There's quite a few ejector pins, mainly along the edge of the wing. There was some on the, one or two I think on the tail. There are also a couple on the tail on, which I actually did notice those ones. I don't know, we didn't notice the other ones, but there we go. But generally, yeah, it is a good kit. I'd thoroughly recommend it. I think they were discontinuing, but if you can get your hands on one, yeah, it's a good kit. It's an absolute beast of a kit, so I've got to find somewhere to store that. But just before we go into it, we're nearly there. I have got the next kit actually lined up, and we're still in the, I'll say, the desert. We're looking at Tanmiers long range desert group vehicle, which is a, if I remember right, it's a Chevrolet, the vehicle is itself. So that's going to be quite cool. I'm going to actually be doing a little diorama with that one as well, so watch out for that one. The first video should be, I'm going to say, the next week or two. I'm not quite sure. I'm a bit going back to work, so it's I don't know what's going on at the moment, but hopefully within the next couple of days, within the next couple of weeks, there should be something coming up, so keep an eye out for that. But thank you very much, guys, if you've managed to listen and stand my babbling up until now. I do hope you've enjoyed the video. If you have and you're not already, please subscribe to the channel. It does help, and I do very, very much appreciate it. Any comments, good or bad, I'm more than happy to receive those from you guys. Again, it does help me. And also, you can follow us on Facebook and on Instagram. So now I've babbled on for way too long. Here's the finished Tornado GR1.